Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1745, More Excel on the iPhone. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. It's July 5th. I don't know if anyone's actually working today. Yesterday was a big holiday in the United States, picnics and fireworks and the whole bit. I bet everyone took the day off. So, hey, we're going to talk about the Excel on the iPhone again today. Yesterday, I guess I was pretty negative. And I'm not, I was hoping I was going to be able to come in today and say something more positive. I wanted to test some real life situations where we started out with an Excel file created in Excel 2013 on the computer and then took a look at how it looked on the iPhone. So here was the original data set. We have a little slicer going on here, you know, which is new in Excel 2013. This is a table, a control T table. I name that table data. Save this out to the SkyDrive and open it. All the data shows up, the slicer is missing, and the table functionality is missing, but you know, I still can see the data. So, all right, there we go. Formatting. Yesterday I complained about four colors of fonts and four colors of fill. If we used formatting on the computer and sent it down to the iPhone, well, the formatting still appeared. And so I tried all kinds of different things here, not just theme colors, you know, more colors and RGB colors, and then some cell styles here, some various underlining here, like a double underline, and a dotted border. Yeah, I was really kind of evil. And center cross selection and merge. You know, my real hope when I started to do this was that when I opened it on the iPhone over here, the merge wouldn't work. And then I'd have something positive to say, hey, at least the iPhone doesn't let you merge cells. But unfortunately, they do let you merge cells. And yesterday I complained that there weren't enough numeric formats on the iPhone. Well, hey, if you create them on the computer, they do all show up correctly on the iPhone. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4.5, 6 with different formattings. And it looks like they all came through, even the comma K to show things in thousands, date and time. I couldn't figure out how to set up a time format on the iPhone, but if I create it on the computer, it does show up correctly on the iPhone. That's a good thing. All right, then I tried some evil things. One of my favorite formulas in the whole world. From February 17, 1965 until today, how many Friday the 13ths are there? We need to see the formula bar here so we can see this view. Formula bar. This is Mike Gervin's version of my formula. So it's not actually an array formula, but the completely evil thing about it is that it's using the row of A2 and the row of B2, which are way beyond 16384, which is how many rows we have on the iPhone. So this thing came in, the columns were not the right width. And again, I don't know how to fix it on the iPhone yet. But the right answer was there. So I was intrigued, how are they getting the right answer? And I wanted to come and change this date. So I clicked in here and you'll notice, I now notice it now, that is grayed out in the formula bar. You click, 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 or tap, 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 tap. They're not going to let you in there. And when I try to format another cell, I get this message, can't edit the workbook. All right, so I've used some rows that are beyond the 16384, and they're going to display it for me. They're going to give me the right answers, give them credit for that. But then we're in can't edit mode. I also tried a true array formula, so equal MMULT to the multiplication table. This is from a podcast a couple of weeks ago. And again, it's grayed out. They don't even show me the formula there, and they show me the value grayed out, not allowed to edit. Let's take a look at some of the features that they planned on working, sorting, filtering, and outline. All right, let's see how those work, because I didn't get to those yesterday. So here's the data set that I started with on the computer. I had groups A and B. I was hoping I was gonna be able to outline this like you could do with subtotals or something like that. And then some reps and some sales so I could sort and filter. Applied an icon set here, applied conditional formatting here, applied a spark line. Open it in Excel on the iPhone, and what do we get? Well, the data is there, that's great. The icon set is gone, the conditional formatting is gone, the spark line does not appear. All right, well, let's try their features. So it's underneath the view features, right? All right, so the first thing I did was I tried outline. Outline, it's not like group an outline that all Excel people know. It's some weird thing where it shows me a list of all of the sheets and it would let me jump to a sheet, I guess. I only had one sheet, so the outline was really, really boring. So click the down arrow to close that. Sort is fairly cool, all right? So I selected the data, and they were able to figure out that the top row were the headings. starts out with sort by none. As soon as I open this flyout menu and choose sales and then descending, look, it sorts instantly. I don't have to click OK or anything like that. It just does the sort. And then I went and chose rep and it sorted back by rep. And I kept thinking, well, I have to click OK, but no, it just does the sort. So that's cool. Sorting works. I'll give you the give them an A plus for the sorting. Filter. Okay. I should have went back and reselected the data. My bad. Later, screenshots, I did go back and reselect the data. So when I applied the filter, they applied it to the top row of my selection. They weren't smart enough to figure out that there were headings above there. But nonetheless, I get the filter dropdowns. I open this filter dropdown and they give me a list of all A or B, turned off B, and then I get a list of A. So that's cool. Let's go on here and try the other one. This little bar here, I didn't mention this yesterday. I said there were only a few commands. We have view cell, we have freeze, wrap, and comment. So you can add a comment to a cell, you can wrap text, you can freeze panes. And view cell, what is view cell? Oh, well, that opens up a screen, a box at the bottom that says this is the cell address and this is the value. So if you had something really, really long there and it was spilling beyond the edge of the cell, you couldn't see all the values, you could view cell with that. And then finally, the last thing on the eyeball menu, the auto sum. Boy, it's not really an auto sum. It's not adding an equal sum formula at the bottom. I was being evil here. I wanted to test and see if they would do the equal subtotal instead of equal sum. It's not any of that at all. It's really the quick sum. It's the totals that appear at the bottom right of your spreadsheet when you select some cells. So when I do this and selected auto sum, they show me the sum, the average, the max, the min, the count. Yeah, that's nice. Do they know the rule that if you apply a filter, they should only show you the visible cells? No, they don't. It's the exact same answer. So here I've applied the filter to group A, and it's still showing me the total of everything. Well, I'm really kind of left speechless on that one. I don't know. Is that a bug? Is that by design? It should at least be consistent with how Excel on the desktop works, or they shouldn't support it. You know, don't give us filters if you're not going to follow the same rules. Well, there you go. All right, so a few different tests on the iPhone, Excel on the iPhone. The formatting does come through very nicely. The sorting does work very nicely. As I mentioned yesterday, my big complaint here is they don't care if you've already given them $399 to buy Excel 2013 Pro Plus. You are going to have to go out and subscribe to Office 365 before you can use Excel on the iPhone. Frankly, I'm just not sure that it's worth it to have to pay them month after month after month when you already own this product on your desktop PC at work or at home or everywhere. They want you to go out and rent this. I just don't get it. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time. I promise to do something that's not Excel on the iPhone. For another netcast from Mr. Excel.